take all I have in these hands and multiply. God, all that I am, and find my heart on the altar again. Set me on fire, set me on fire. Oh, take all I have in these hands and multiply. God, all that I am, and find my heart on the altar again. Set me on fire, well, set me on fire. Here I am, God, arms wide. For me, you won't forsake me, you will be with me. Here I am, God, arms wide open, oh, pouring out my life, gracefully broken, pouring out my life again. Here I am. Arms wide open.
feeding the 5,000 and just taking little and blessing it and seeing the abundance that he provides for people. And we just know that we live in an abundance through your mercy and through your grace. And let us just live in that abundance that you have given to us and share that with those that we come in contact with. And so we just ask for your presence this morning as we are fed through your word. It's in your name we pray. Amen. So I invite you to stand and join in singing our first hymn, Christ is our Cornerstone. Let us then confess our sins to God, our Father. Most merciful God, we have
confessed that we are by nature sinful and unclean.
We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all your sins. As a called ordained servant of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord remembered us in our low estate.
His steadfast love endures forever.
He rescued us from our foes. He gives food to all flesh.
His steadfast love endures forever.
Give thanks to the God of heaven God who began this good work within you, bring it to completion on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. And the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
And let us pray. Heavenly Father, though we do not deserve your goodness, still you provide for all our needs of body and soul. Grant us your Holy Spirit that we may acknowledge your gifts, give thanks for all your benefits, and serve you in willing obedience. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated. So we begin a new month here in the month of August, and we have a new memory verse. And so this month we're going to just look at where we keep our eyes focused on. As so many of those that have been just trying to plan kind of focus on themselves and what can we do? How are we going to do this? And we forget to where we need to keep our eyes focused on. And so here in Psalm 123, that first verse reminds us to lift up your eyes to the heavens, to know that God is in control, his plans are perfect, and he will guide us through this pandemic, that he will guide us through the rest of our lives. And so let us commit this to memory. When you came in, or as you leave, there is a slip there that you can take with you and just commit that to memory. And so let us say this verse twice this morning. To you, I lift up my eyes.
How are you? Psalm
123. One more time. Our Old Testament reading this morning comes from the book of Isaiah, the 55th chapter. Come, everyone who thirsts, come to the waters. And he who has no money, come, buy and eat. Come, buy wine and milk, without money and without price. Why do you spend your money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which does not satisfy? Listen diligent to me, and eat what is good, and delight yourselves in rich food. Incline your ear and come to me. Hear, that your soul may live, and I will make with you an everlasting covenant, my steadfast, sure love for David. Behold, I made a witness to the peoples, a leader and a commander for the peoples. Behold, you shall call a nation that you do not know, and a nation that did not know, you shall run, and that you shall run to you, because of the Lord your God and the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. And this is the word of the Lord. Our epistle reading this morning comes from Paul's letter to the Romans, the 9th chapter. I'm speaking the truth in Christ. I am not lying. My conscience bears me witness in the Holy Spirit that I have great sorrow and unceasing anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my brothers, my kinsmen, according to the flesh. They are Israelites, and to them belong the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. To them belong the patriarchs, and from their race, according to the flesh, is the Christ who is God over all, blessed forever. Amen. But it is not as though the word of God has failed, for not all who are descendants from Israel belong to Israel, and not all children of Abraham because they are his offspring, but through Isaac your offspring shall be named. This means that it is not the children of the flesh who are the children of God, but the children of the promise are counted as offspring. For this is what the promise said. About this time next year, I will return and Sarah shall have a son. And not only so, but also when Rebekah had conceived children by one man, our forefather Isaac, though they were not yet born and had not done anything either good or bad,
in order that God's purpose of election might continue, not because of works, but because of his call. She was told, the older will serve the younger. As it is written, Jacob I loved, but Esau I hated. And this is the word of the Lord. This time I invite the children out there to come and join me for a children's message this morning. I invite you to stand if you are able and let us say the verse together. Alleluia. Men may ate of the bread of the angels. He sent them food in abundance. Alleluia. The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 14th chapter. Now when Jesus heard about the death of John, he withdrew from there in a boat to a desolate place by himself. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion on them and healed their sick. Now when it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a desolate place, and the day is now over. Send the crowds away to go into the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said, "They need not go away. You give them something to eat." They said to him, "We only have 5 loaves here and 2 fish. And he said, "Bring them here to me." Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass, and taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven and said, "A blessing." Then he broke the loaves and gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the crowds. And they all ate and were satisfied. And they took up 12 baskets full of the broken pieces left over. And those who ate were about 5,000 men, besides women and children. This is the gospel of the Lord. We continue with our next hymn, which is one of Gail Klug's favorites, "Beautiful Savior."
Thank you.
Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God, our Heavenly Father, and through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who gives to us abundantly for all that we need. Be with you all. Amen. You may be seated. For the past few weeks, we have been looking at the parables of Jesus, those teachings that he gives to the people, to us, that we certainly can learn from. And now we're going to spend the next couple of weeks looking at the miracles of Jesus. Now, certainly the miracles of Jesus is a fascinating thing to look at. To look at all that he does. His control over nature, healing people, catching abundance of fish, speaking something and it happens. The list goes on and on. Certainly things that we wish we could have seen. And today we're going to look at one of the miracles that Jesus does, and that feeding of the 5,000. And taking the little that he had been giving and making it into an abundance. Feeding everyone so that they were satisfied, having leftovers. And so when we look at this text, the first thing to me that stood out was, again, that word compassion. We looked at this a couple weeks ago and how Jesus looked upon the crowds and had compassion on them. For they knew that they didn't have someone to lead them. They were like sheep that had gone astray. They needed a shepherd. So Jesus once again looks upon the crowd and has compassion on them. We see that all Jesus wanted to do was get away. He had just learned about the death of John. All he wanted to do was get away, be alone. So he does. He gets in a boat and he goes to a desolate place. But of course, the crowds follow Jesus. And when he gets there, what happens but crowds are there? Jesus once again has compassion on them and he heals the sick, the people that were there. And certainly this took all day. As we see from the text, it is now evening when the disciples come to Jesus. Notice that he refused to send them away. The compassion that he has for them is in an abundance, and he heals them, and he provides for them. These are certainly actions of one who cares about those in need. The next part that really sticks out to me, and I want to spend some time on, is that conversation between Jesus and his disciples. The disciples, seeing that it is late, it is evening, they come to Jesus, say, "I think it's time for these people to go away. We have nothing to give to them. Have them go into the village and eat." Now, certainly where they are, there are not a lot of towns around. We look at it, they're just small towns. They're probably the size of Sabin, probably smaller. So you can imagine if 5,000 plus people are in the park out here, and the disciples tell Jesus, "Why don't you have everyone go to the crowbar and eat?" What's going to happen to the crowbar? Probably going to get excited, but then after a few hundred people, they're probably going to run out of food. And so Jesus, I think, knows this and kind of questions them of, why would you send them to a desolate place? They're in a desolate place. Why would you send them to the neighboring villages? Why don't you feed them? They don't need to go away. You give them something to eat. Now, certainly we can imagine the looks on the disciples' face when Jesus tells them that. For as they are looking at what they have, 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish, And then scanning the crowd, kind of going, how are we going to do this? Jesus tells them, go, feed them. Jesus, of course, has them sit down. He said, bring me the food that you have. And like always, Jesus takes it, blesses it, breaks it, gives it back to the disciples and says, now go and feed them. We know that the crowd was fed. And they weren't just given just a small amount, but they were satisfied. They supersized their meal, they got what they wanted, and more, are satisfied. Then they go around after everyone has eaten, and they gather the leftovers. And it's not just a few crumbs. These are fairly big baskets, and there are 12 of them that are filled with the leftovers. Certainly this is one of the miracles that fascinates me. And I wish I could just stand up and watch as the disciples take what has been given to them and people are given food. And row after row, the food continues. An amazing thing to witness. As it keeps going and going and going, it's not like they run out when they get to the back. No, they have the leftovers. But where did this food come from? How did this go from just 5 loaves and 2 fish to feeding probably close to 7,000-8,000 people? And we certainly see the abundance that God gives to us. Certainly, it points me back to Revelation 21, where we hear that when we get to heaven, we will never thirst nor hunger. It will be like this miracle each and every day of our lives. What we need will be given to us, and given to us in abundance. We will have everything that we need. And this is what Christ is for us. Christ is our living bread, and he gives to us in an abundance. And certainly people say that miracles don't happen today, that he doesn't provide for us like he once did. I think we all can beg to differ that miracles don't happen. Miracles happen each and every day. It's a miracle that we wake up each and every morning. It's a miracle that our heart continues to pump oxygen and blood to our bodies without us even thinking about it. It's a miracle that each and every day new children are brought into this world. It's a miracle that we have food to eat. I think we always think of miracles as something big and extravagant, and I think we lose sight of the fact of what God does in providing for us. We have a place each and every Sunday to come and worship him. Some parts of the world, they would love to have that opportunity. That's a miracle that we have a place that we can come and freely worship. Gather together, that we have a family here that we can rely on. I'm sure that when you stop and look around, see how God provides for you, you will see that miracles happen each and every day. Take that time and remember where those things come from. They come from him. Then to think what heaven is going to be like, where we will have everything that we need, but more importantly, we will be face to face with our provider and our Savior. What an amazing place and sight that will be. I'm sure we all can't wait to see it. So I want to leave with you that conversation between Jesus and his disciples. Let's look back at that. And the fact that he tells them to go and feed them. The disciples came to Jesus and say, this is what we got. We got 5 loaves and 2 fish. What do you want us to do with it? He says, go and take it and feed the people. We can do that as well. We all have different gifts and vocations. We can come to our Heavenly Father and say, Heavenly Father, this is all that I got. God will take what we have, the gifts that we have, will bless it, and then he will tell us to go feed people, feed the children. We take what we have and we give it back to God. God will bless it. And I know that when God takes what we give to him, he will do more than we can ever imagine. But let us look at the abundance that we have in this life, all that he has to give to us in heaven, and go and feed the people. Tell people about Jesus. Tell people about the miracles that are still happening today. But more importantly, tell about our living bread in Jesus. He is all that we need. He is our beautiful Savior. He is our cornerstone. Hold on to that. Watch him bless your work for his kingdom. Let us continually go out to feed the people, to strengthen them through the word, the everlasting word that is in his word. Miracles still happen today. We need to open our eyes, see how God is blessing his people. Feed the people. To God be the glory forever and ever. Amen. And I invite you to stand if you are able as we join together in confessing the words of the Apostles' Creed. And we confess, I believe in God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended into heaven. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Hungry and thirsty, we come to you, O Lord, and we pray you to supply us with all things needful to this body and life, and to teach us to receive your gifts with thanksgiving. Lord, in your mercy. With restless hearts, we come to you, O Lord, and we pray that by faith we rest our hopes, dreams, anxieties, and needs upon your everlasting arms and find contentment and peace. Lord, in your mercy. Knowing that you have established your church by your word and spirit and endowed her with the means of grace, we pray for those who serve us in your name, for our synodical president, our district president, and for our pastors and DCEs and all church workers, to raise up those who will follow in their footsteps and serve you faithfully on our behalf. Lord, in your mercy. Knowing that all power is yours, both in heaven and on earth, we thank you for all the blessings bestowed upon us in this nation, and for those who govern for the protection of the weak,
the punishment of the evildoer and the encouragement of virtue. Lord, in your mercy. Broken and wounded, we come to you, O Lord, for healing, comfort, and consolation. Hear us on behalf of all those who cry to you in any need, especially to those in this congregation, for Penny, Marlis, Ryan, Danny, Cody, Sam, Betty, Jim, Barb, Joanne, Robert, Sarah, Helen, Wayne, Karen, Dawn, and Chase. May your gracious will be done and all preserved in affliction and raised to everlasting life. Lord, in your mercy. Mindful of the poor and those who struggle with daily needs, we ask you, O Lord, to grant us the good fruits of the earth and the fruits of our honest labors to supply what we need and for the poor, the needy, and the unemployed. Lord, in your mercy. Almighty God, we rejoice with those who rejoice, especially those who celebrate a birthday this week. For Amaya, Jesse, Amy, Teresa, Erica, Randy, Ashley, and Morgan. We also thank you for your continued blessings on marriages, especially to Pastor Brett and Carrie, Jeff and Rayanne, Josh and Shayla, Dell and Jessica, and Herman and Renee, who celebrate another year of marriage this week. Lord, in your mercy. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend ourselves and all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. You may be seated. This is our time to offer up our offerings to our Heavenly Father. And so if you didn't do that when you came in, certainly the offering plates are located at the exits there. You can place them in. Also, we'll be celebrating Holy Communion this morning. So if you did not pick up your individual communion kits when you came in, those are on the outsides of the doorways there. You can certainly go and pick them up during this time of offering. As we just reflect on these words that God has for us through this song. And so sit back and enjoy this short clip. Jesus Christ our Lord, who out of love for his fallen creation humbled himself by taking on the form of a servant, becoming obedient unto death, even death upon a cross. Risen from the dead, he freed us from eternal death and gives to us life everlasting. And therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying,
Amen.
mercy of old and how you sustained your people with the manna supplied from heaven. By this miracle bread you have given a hint of the bread that is Christ's flesh and feeds us everlasting life. Give us grateful hearts to receive with joy the manifold blessings with which you have supplied our body. Give us faith to receive worthily the great blessing of Christ's flesh and blood in this blessed supper. Guard us from pride and teach us humility that we come with repentance and receive with confidence the mystery of Christ's flesh in this sacrament. Help us to keep this holy life, what we receive upon our lips today. And guard our life together until you deliver us into your presence on high. Our Lord Jesus Christ, the night he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to his disciples, said to them, "Take and eat. This is my body which was given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave to them and said, "Take and drink. This cup is the New Testament in my blood which is shed for you, for the forgiveness of all your sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Let us join together in praying the prayer our Lord has taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. You may be seated. I invite you to take out your individual communion cups and peel back the side with the bread. Take and eat. This is Christ's true body given and shed for you. I may peel back the side of the wine. Take and drink. This is Christ's true blood given and shed for you for the forgiveness of all your sins. Now, having received Christ's true body and blood, may it strengthen you and preserve you and your flesh until life everlasting. Depart in our risen Lord's peace. Your sins are forgiven. Amen. Let us join in singing our next hymn, "Give Thanks with a Grateful Heart."
Thank you. let's stand, if you are able, for prayer. Let us pray. Almighty God, in our want we cry to you, and you answer us with the food of your mercy and grace in Christ our Savior. Keep us from being satisfied by things that have no power to forgive our sins or lead us to everlasting life. Lead us to trust in you, for your grace will not disappoint us, and your gifts satisfy us today and through all eternity. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
We join in our ascending prayer, and as we begin this new month, we also join together with all the churches of the Minnesota North District who will be praying this prayer today. Be reminded that we go out and we proclaim the abundance that we have in Christ, who is our living bread. And so we pray, Lord God, Heavenly Father, we are living through difficult times. People are hurting. Need hope despite the restrictions we face due to the virus. Give us opportunity to tell someone we know about your love and forgive us. Someone we know needs hope. Use us to give your hope to them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
And now receive our Lord's benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and grant you his peace. We conclude with our final hymn, Lord, dismiss us with your blessing.